Scientists described Gobi hadros in 2019 off a very well-preserved skeleton, and the skull in particular was wildly, wildly well-preserved. But there's a few other specimens of Gobi hadros that do also exist. And one of these in particular has a lot of issues with the skeleton, not because of any particular issue with the research that was taking place on it, but because it was a very old animal. Not necessarily like old in the fossil record, but no, it as an individual was old. And honestly, this is the first time we found something that can be distinctly described as an old dinosaur, as opposed to one that just died of any other cause. So it's actually given us a really big window into what old dinosaurs may have been like. Part of the evidence that it was an old animal are the transcortical canals that flow into the femur to essentially help that bone grow were entirely closed. So those go to feed the epiphyseal plate, which is essentially the growth plate of cartilage in long bones in tetrapods. Because those canals were closed, it means that that plate was not getting any blood flow or extra nutrients, so it was totally done growing. Additionally, there's lines of arrested growth, so essentially where the animal had to slow down its growth because the conditions weren't right, and this normally happened yearly. However, towards the outer edge of the bone, these become much more densely compact, so essentially the animal slowed down its growth a lot there. Functionally, it didn't grow at all. However, there's also other things that suggest that it was old, other than just reaching what was probably their maximum size of around 7.5 meters, or about 25 feet. The evidence that this animal is old, and not just fully grown, comes in the shape of some calcium deposits on a few of the bones. These have shown a lot of similarity to calcium pyrophosphate deposition disease, which is a disease that shows up in a lot of different animals, but it doesn't really show up until later in life. For example, in humans, it doesn't really show up until after 55 years of age. And it's a disease in which, essentially, the body is unable to lay down calcium in a normal way on the bones, instead laying down calcium pyrophosphate, which is a different kind of chemical. This causes conditions that are very similar to things like arthritis, meaning that this dinosaur would have been somewhat arthritic and not necessarily as good at moving as other dinosaurs, which may have been younger. However, there's more to it than just that, and specifically, it's the remodeling of weight-bearing bones. As animals, including humans, age, their muscles get weaker, and that means the bones need to do more work to try and hold up the body. And we can see that in this animal, where while the bones weren't necessarily growing, they were remodeling and reshaping themselves, essentially becoming thicker to help deal with the stress of holding up the animal's body weight. And again, that's because its muscle mass couldn't hold it up alone, and it needed these stronger bones to be able to keep standing. This distinctly aged dinosaur may actually help researchers understand some younger dinosaurs even better. And that's because there's some features that were thought to be associated with old age that may actually not be, such as fused vertebra, something that was, again, thought to be associated with old age but could actually happen even when the animal was younger, whereas these features are distinctly showing old age. In fact, because this dinosaur is so distinctly aged, the authors are able to propose a guideline for other researchers to understand if their dinosaurs that they're researching are distinctly aged. And these are things like maximum size based on the presence or absence of the transcortical canals, and things like the lines of arrested growth becoming much more dense on the outer layer of the bone. But then also the other things that are associated with age. So things like the remodeling of bone, and other things like the disease, the calcium pyrophosphate deposition disease. These are all things that may exist more in the fossil record, but haven't been specifically recognized before this paper. So hopefully it will lay down the groundwork for more researchers to try and understand if they just have old dinosaurs, or if some of them, or most of them that we have in the fossil record, died younger than that. But beyond that, it does go to show that dinosaurs weren't necessarily anything special, despite living for so long and for so many millions of years. Instead, they faced different diseases, just like humans do. And they may have even faced things like diabetes, like I do. We don't necessarily know, and that will be very hard to prove, because it's going to be hard to find that kind of soft tissue preservation. But it does go to show, again, that they're not anything special. They're just like any other animal trying to live their lives. And while evolution does happen on a long timescale, there's differences that do occur over very short timescales that may mean that dinosaurs and potentially other animals may not make it.